All right. Thank you so much for having me. So I've changed the title slightly. So I'm going to, but very, very similar. So I'm going to talk about education, family life, and AI in post-xiaokang China, new parenting practices through home technology. I'm a fourth-year PhD researcher in global studies at the University of Sussex. And for a little bit of context, I've been doing fieldwork, longitudinal fieldwork, for about like 5 years now. And in my ethnographic fieldwork, I've been following the lives of urban, middle class, and upper middle class families in China who invest heavily in their children's education and also adopt modern child-rearing styles to provide a happy childhood and slower-paced life in a dehumanizing, hyper-competitive education system. Post-xiaokang, I was very inspired by this. It was coined by two current party members. Post-xiaokang refers to a projected future when universal prosperity has been achieved and people stop being driven by only material values and improve social relations and eventually slow down and work on social relations. In this current setting, I'm interested in some of the contradictions now further challenged by AI, especially in education. So these contradictions, meaning the continued pursuit of educational achievements and their effect on family members' connections and to one another in a child and child-centered relatedness, using the indigenous concept of qinjin, meaning how the family members show love and care towards each other, which has actually improved very much in recent years. For further context, I'd like to talk just for a few seconds about this, how the state has been promoting through these images in various channels, family planning, incentivizing, promoting couples to have more than one child since the one child policy has ended. So it's very much part of the narrative these days that people should be, focusing on the family, have more children, and focus on their relationship with each other. So my questions for today are, how has AI been used in happy education in a home environment? And how has AI been shaping parenting and the everyday lives of families? So just very briefly, through my ethnographic empirical findings, I have found the following, that in recent years, through talking to the parents, educational experts, teachers, education consultants, parents, AI, drone, and computer programming classes from grade 10, so from around the age of 10, have become very, very popular as elective classes. Jumu, a lot of online classes through these platforms have become the norm, especially since the COVID-19 outbreak, when children had to follow up with the classes online. So there are two issues here. Not only that, it sort of extends the time so that parents or families can take advantage of tutors available time who live abroad, and then now children end up having online tutoring classes as late as 10 p.m. on a Friday or on a Sunday. But these sessions are automatically recorded without asking for prior consent from the tutor or the child. So there are also a lot of apps that children use, and they have become very, very popular. For example, Xuarsi, and these softwares help after school, after the extra tutoring classes. They also can practice math skills, for example, by themselves. And this is also very interesting in my research, because parents shared with me that since their children study such high levels and in English, they sometimes feel incompetent, that they cannot just sit with the child and help doing their homework because they don't quite keep up with what these children are studying. And now there is also the added problem of digital literacy, that now these young children know how to do programming and use these AI-assisted programs, and that the parent has very little knowledge about this and they cannot help. So in my research, I'm also doing or paying a lot of focus on how family members imagine free time and how free time is well spent. And in my findings, it transpires that a lot of these free time activities are very much productive or purpose driven. And the AI-assisted robots or software also join in this style of having free time. The other interesting thing is that parents, especially in urban settings, started to attend parent education courses and programs informed by Western and Chinese psychology. And these programs about good parenting also use AI assisted softwares, and the parents at the end of the day or at the end of the week, they fill in softwares or quizzes, sorry, and they compete with themselves and each other what they did on a given day and whether they are becoming better parents or not. So in order to escape a digitized or competitive system, this also in a way exacerbates competition because they are measuring themselves on a constant basis. So just going back to the state and promoting a happy childhood or happy families, the state introduced a double reduction policy aiming to reduce the study burden for children and the costs for parents. At the same time, schools have been promoting a digital childhood and these softwares. So through these ethnographic findings, I've been observing how the child and parent interact in a physical environment with each other. How the children interact with their peers, how they communicate or what they play. And there's also a new phenomenon that emerged recently called social involution, meaning that people are realizing that they are in this trap of a cycle of competition, whereas all this hard work might not yield results in the future because the labor market has become very, very competitive. And just last to finish off, I'd like to show you an example by a commercial company called Linji Technology. Again, this happy life is very much part of the narrative through AI-assisted machines that take care of the home environment, like the thermostat, the ideal temperature in the home. The narrative is very much that parents can spend more time with each other and they can enhance family connection. And again, I very much like, it's the same company, and I very much liked the images here. Again, the one child, but the in the first picture, but then in the second picture, the grandparent, the parents, and two children now spending quality time with each other. Enhanced by technology. And again, AI is very much promoted to help parents help their children to learn. At the same time, and very much going back to this Xiaokang narrative, there's a lot of demand from parents to learn how to connect with their children. For example, there's a library, not in Shanghai, but in Foshan, very close to Hong Kong, where this library is offering programs or a space for parents and children to just sit down, leave all the gadgets and the smartphone outside, and just learn through books and just connecting to each other on an organic basis. That's what I wanted to say today. Thank you so much.